One of my good friends, professional football player, I've heard him say this over and over. I don't know how I feel about him saying it. What do you feel about the phrase, give back, but don't go back?
That's totally incorrect.
Okay.
And I'm going to tell you why. Giving back, okay,
yeah,
may provide some financial resources.
Yeah.
But going back provides an intangible psychological stimulation and motivation for the children
to
want to do better.
Yeah.
Your presence
yeah.
is infinitely more important than your profit.
Okay.
And then we turn around and blame the hip-hop artists
yeah.
for being bad role models. Lil Wayne ain't supposed to be a role model.
Right.
Jeezy ain't supposed to be a role model.
Not at all.
The reason why they're role models
yeah.
is because the real role models turn their backs on little black boys. See, 50 years ago, the dentist lived on the block. 60 years ago, the doctor lived on the block. The yeah. engineer lived on the block. Right. The electrician lived on the block.
Yeah.
Now they move out and they get mad at the rappers. The only reason why Lil Wayne is a role model is because the doctor, lawyer, dentist, and engineer ran to a white suburb and probably married a white woman.
I saw a video on that. Talk briefly about that.
Okay.
And then I'm gonna get into what I'm going to get into.
No problem.
But talk briefly
yes, sir.
About the black man and white woman. Go ahead.
Okay.
Yeah.
Historically,
yeah.
black men were not allowed to marry white women until the Loving versus Virginia United States Supreme Court case in the 60s.
Yeah.
You could not marry them. So since that case was overturned, 67, 68, right around there,
yeah.
black men have married out their race more than all other men in America put together. Are you going to tell me it's a pure coincidence that the black man is absolutely in love
yeah.
with marrying his oppressor's daughter and that that doesn't have anything to do with the psychological residuals of slavery?
I'm going to give it to you on the flip side.
Go ahead.
Do you think it's a lot of the black man saying, I got to go have that white woman? Or some of these white women out here looking at, that's a god right there. I want that.
Mm-hmm. It's threefold.
Okay.
Number one, it's about a black man being an economic stimulus package to the white woman.
Okay.
Most black men
yeah.
marry down in class when they marry these white women.
Okay.
You can't find a rich white woman who ever married a broke-ass black man.
Boy.
Show me one rich white woman who has ever married a broke-ass black man. So this ain't about love. This is about agenda.
Okay.
That's number one. Number two, the black man wants the white woman to provide him with a degree of psychological validation. Only a low self-esteem having ass Negro would marry a white female in the first place, because you feel that if I can get the white man's woman, then maybe that makes me feel a little bit more equal to the
like
white, man.
White man.
And then thirdly, you're absolutely right. Mm-hmm. We're the gods.
Mm-hmm.
We are the first man.
Yeah, yeah.
So naturally, white women are going to be attracted to us because we are the original man.
Mm-hmm.
Everyone is attracted to melanin. Yeah.
There you go.
It is liquid gold.
What?
But you have to love your liquid gold enough to say that y'all have miscegenized us enough.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all have blended us and crossbred us enough. And I'm not going to continue to perpetuate that evil. This melanin is going to go into another melanin. We're trying to make black blacker, not black whiter.